Countdown 2019, a cursed app on your phone. If you break the terms of service, which are extensive, will cause you to be dead very soon by demonic force, basically, and they fight to stay alive. Twist at the end that's extremely expected, but that's the way these movies go. It was well executed, well acted, and well scripted. Lots of action, lots of fun, lots of great effects. 7 out of 10. By the way, the app's real. Earth and Blood, 2020. It's from France. It's a meh, but it's not a super meh. 4 out of 10. Hillbilly Elegy. An elegy is a poem, by the way. It's a style of poem. Anywho, this could have been better. The concept is really sound. The acting was acceptable, but the script just wasn't there, and it just didn't do it for me. But I'm going to give it a pass. It's 5 out of 10. I'm pretty sure most people are going to like this movie more than I did. It's a sort of family drama type thing there, with your roots and who you are versus who you want to be and stuff like that, Okay, try about 100 billion. The Shadow of Violence. This is an Irish film. About somebody who's in with a very, very, very bad crowd, and he's not a bad person. He's just born into a world where this is really his only option. At the end, he tries to redeem himself and make a better life for his child, but it's too late. There's a tragic ending, but a very beautiful ending at the same time, because the child does get a better life. It was violent. It was moving. It was a little bit slow, and for some reason, everywhere in the entire universe, this movie is called Sh The Shadow of Violence, except on IMDb, where it's called Calm with Horses, and I have no idea why. The son is actually calm with horses. He's autistic, and when he's riding the horse, he's nice and calm and all that stuff. But literally, the movie's rolling at the beginning. The title comes up, The Shadow of Violence. Rotten Tomatoes has it as that. There's a billion trailers and clips and reviews on YouTube calling it The Shadow of Violence, but IMDb calls it something completely else, which isn't the first time I've run into that. Anyways, 9 out of 10. The Power of the Dog, 2021. Two brothers who have a fairly substantial ranch go on a cattle drive. One of them sort of falls in love. One of them, less rough brother who's evolved with the times. This is the 1920s now, and he sort of evolved with the times. He's become a more very mannered person, and his rough and gruff brother doesn't like the woman he's fallen in love with, and the rather feminine boy that she is raising. He basically bullies the hell out of the lot of them, and there's a lot of tension and whatnot. Anyways, it's a not terrible movie, and it's a not great movie. It's really slow. I mean, it's really slow. It's over 2 hours long, a little over 2 hours. This could have been 90 minutes and still done what it did. A little bit more effectively, I think. That being said, I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10.